Today we will be going to have the journey of their definitions. So let's move there. And I literally segregated the definition in long definition and small definition, which will be easy for you to remember, recollect and reproduce during exam. So likewise, these 14 definitions are there in our syllabus. Okay. Out of them, 5 are lengthy definition and 9 are short definitions. In lengthy definition, we have business, consideration, India, person, recipient, which are very, very important and very vital as far as GST is concerned. And in short definitions, we have supplier, services, taxable person, taxable supplier, goods, etc. So many of these definitions we have learned earlier also in one or other act. So let us start with the definition of business. I believe this definition you have learned earlier also. Is there anyone who can explain me or something regarding definition of business? If you can recollect a little bit. You must have seen this definition in so many different acts. Even in the junior college also you have seen, you must have gone through the concept of business. Anyone who can help me? See, these definitions are very important because definitely there will be such, you must have seen in this exam, your semester 5, and as well as in semester 6, this definition will be definitely part and parcel of your question. So business includes, so like what we had the definition of person in semester 5, inclusive definitions are very dangerous definition. Okay, because that never restricts. Very good, Sanovar. Thanks, Veta, for your attempt. Okay. So, whenever it is inclusive, that is very dangerous. Okay. Anything could be considered as business. Okay. Could be trading, where you are not manufacturing, just merely buying and selling. They are the business, commerce. So, even you have seen the definition of your person, which was an inclusive definition, that is very vast in nature. So whatever is things defined in the act, that is to there only. Beyond this also many things covers. Okay, so business includes any trade, commerce, manufacture, profession, vocation, adventure, wager or any other similar activity, whether or not it is for, I mean, everything, trade, commerce, manufacture, profession is also business. Earlier, these words were not there. Wager were not there. So these are few new words which has been, incorporated in this definition of Section 2, Subsection 17 of CGST Act. Section 2 and Subsection 17 of CGST Act. Okay, I mean, you must have seen the labor contractors, they are also included. All services, professional people are also included as a business. That is why they are chargeable to GST. So first they have, what the government has done, they have incorporated everything. Thank you, Rutuja. Then any activity or transaction in connection with or incidental or ancillary. So not only this, even though it's not trade, but if I'm assisting trade, if I'm helping trade, how we can help the trade? Suppose I'm not the trader, but I am the, you know, supplier to the trader. I'm the person who is warehouse the product for those traders. Are you getting or not? Then those incidental or ancillary things will also, activity will also be a part and parcel of definition of business. That is going to incorporate there. Okay. Any activity or transaction in nature of subclause A. This is, so this is definition, section 17, section 2, subsection 17, clause A. So they are stating any transaction in the nature of subclause A, whether or not in the volume, frequency, continuity, regularity of such transactions. So what used to happen earlier, there were certain traders who were not in continuation of business. Okay, frequency was not there, continuity was not there. Say for example, there were seasonal kind of trader. Like, you know, we are approaching 14 January and all. So there is a kite, you know, and before that we have seen crackers. So these kind of businesses are seasonal in nature. They never cover under business and they never used to pay the tax. Now what the government has done? Government incorporated everyone. They have not excluded anyone with the volume, with the frequency, with the continuity, with the regularities, everything they have incorporated. So just try to understand, if you see the previous definition and this definition, there are many new things which have been incorporated here. If you see the definition of, MVAT, where the business has been explained, or CST, where the business has been explained, or sale of goods act, where the business has been explained. This all has a different perception than this revised definition of business. And of course, the subsection is totally different. So try to understand these things has broader in area, broader in concept, broader in nature. Okay. Then we also include here supply or acquisition of capital goods. Okay. In connection of commencement or closure of the business. Even you are doing the wind up and then also you are doing something like that, which has some capital goods transaction or services, all are business. If why they are broadening the definition of business, if it will be there in the purview of business, then only they can charge the GST. Try to understand. So that was the basic, and that is why you must have seen the ranging of business, your tax collection. There is huge difference between earlier tax collection. Of course, always indirect tax was instrumental for Indian government to have the revenue. But since this GST has been incorporated, it has much broader in nature. They have collected huge amount because of these kind of things which has been incorporated in different ways and means. As they have simplified, there is no more complications, things are clear to the businessman or anyone who is providing any kind of supply, so they are ready to pay. And there is no cascading effect. Once they paid, they are free. Simple. And they need not have to keep many records, because records are subsequently there with the government also. Okay? Even they have included club, association, societies. These were excluded in earlier definition of business. So they used to define business separately. They used to define dealer separately. Now everything is clubbed together. Okay? Try to understand, they even included admission, consideration, you know, to any premises. All services, specifically they have stated, all services supplied by a person holder of an office which has been accepted by him in course of furtherness of his trade, profession or vocation. Furtherness means what? When they were transforming from earlier indirect tax to the recent regime of GST. Till then also the business were continued. So all they have, incorporated. They have not left even government also. Might be central government or state government. Everything they have incorporated under one umbrella. And that is why in many of the government services, even in railway when you are taking, they are charging GST from you. I hope things are clear as far as definition of business is concerned. Can we proceed to the next definition? Okay. So the next definition what we have is definition of consideration. I hope this definition you have learned a lot when we were there in SYBCOM and learning the Contract Act. Yes or no? Are you able to recollect the definition of consideration which we have learned in Contract Act? The same definition is again, yes, something in return. Yes. Thank you, Mithil, for your answer. Yes. So same thing has been even incorporated here, okay? But in a different prospect, in the prospects of GST. So here it is, consideration in relation to supply of goods or services or both includes any payment made or to be made, whether in money or otherwise. Try to understand when we had earlier also definition of consideration, whether we have done something or we'll be doing something, whether it is in cash or whether it is in kind or any promises to do or not to do, etc. All were consideration. Suppose I'm going to a shopkeeper and buying a pen. Getting that pen is consideration for me. That cash, whatever 10, 20 rupees he's charging, that is consideration for him. Likewise. Which Mittal has very rightly stated, something in return. It might be in goods, it might be in services, it might be in promises, it might be doing something, it might be not doing it, something, etc. All will be part and parcel of consideration. So any payment made or to be made, whether in money or otherwise. So now you will understand everything in respect of, in response to, or for the inducement of the supply of goods, services or both, whether the recipient or by other person, but shall not include any subsidies. That is why when we will do the, this all will help you a lot when you will do the sums or applicability of GST. So this subsidy when we will do, yes and over. Very good. So this will also not to be incorporated when we will deal with section 15, which talks about value of supply. There also we will exclude. This will excluded at many times. Okay, when we will deal with registration, when we will deal with ITC. Why? Because from the very initial definition under section 2, subsection 31, clause A, it has been excluded by the government in the act. So it never includes, okay, any subsidy given by central or state government. Next, we have the monetary value of any act or forbearance in respect of or in response of for the inducement of supply of goods or services or both, whether the recipient, that is why, see, so many places we are going to have this word recipient, which were not used in previous act, neither in Sale of Goods Act nor in Negotiable Instrument Act. There you have heard the word of drawee, endorser, endorsee, etc., etc. So recipient has been separately defined in this act, and it also includes central government, state government, anything. Okay, is a part and parcel of consideration. Next we have India, because GST is applicable whole of India, so that is why they, and it also incorporated Jammu and Kashmir. So actually J&K was a part of India since 2017 only, when they have introduced this act. India means territory of India as referred to Article 1 of Constitution. It's territorial water, okay, subsoils, underlying water. So everything which is there as not disputed areas like EOK and all, rest all it will be part and parcel of definition of India. Then person, I expect this definition you do it with your own. What do you mean by person? During last semester we had lot of discussion. Can anybody tell something about person? Just try to recollect and remember. Person includes, yes or no? Again, inclusive definition. Yes or no? Individual, HUF, AOP, BOI. Can you able to recollect? Yes. Same kind of definition is here also. Dekho, as it is. But they have extended, which were not there in Income Tax Act 1961. They have incorporated. They have incorporated LLP and all these words were not there in 1961. That is why those things has not been incorporated in definition of person of Income Tax Act 1961. But by now, these all are there. So they have incorporated in definition of person, which is defined under CGST Act 2017 by Government of India. So again, same thing. Again, inclusive means very dangerous. An individual, HUF, company, firm, LLP, association of person, corporation, body incorporate, cooperative society, local authority, central government, society, trust, artificial judicial person. And if the word is inclusive there, it includes many other things. So I think all five lengthy definitions are over. Now let us go for short definition, which is first electronic commerce operator under section 2, subsection 45. Electronic commerce operator means any person who owns, because these definitions you will not find in Income Tax Act 1961 or Sale of Goods Act or Partnership Act 1932, because that time there were no electronic commerce operators. That is why amendment in acts are very important. Revisions in act is very important. Till today we are following Partnership Act 1932, which is Britishers Act. Till today we are following Negotiable Instrument Act 1887. Right? More than 100 years thing. Do you think it is going to have any relevance as if now? Things are totally different. How many of you are using the promissory notes? Things are changing. So we have to change our act. That's very important. And why we are electing the government? To make new acts. Rather than having the agitations and other things. So electronic commerce operator means any person who owns, operates or manages digital or electronic facility platforms in electronic commerce. Can you tell me any examples of electronic commerce operators? Very important in today's world. And you must be using. Get me any example, if you can. And this all, if suppose there is objective type of exam, be careful. That is why I'm giving a lot of stress to the theories. Otherwise, it would not have been given. All e-wallet, Paytm, Airtel, Google Pay, this all cover under electronic commerce operator. Your Amazon, anything, they do the commercial activity online. Goods, I think I need not have to explain. You have learned several occasions. Yes or no? Goods you have studied or not? In several occasions, you must have studied the definition of goods. Same thing, every kind of movable property other than money or security, improved sustainable claim, growing crops, yeah, as it is what we had earlier, same thing is here also. Non-taxable supply means supply of goods and services or both which are not levable tax. I will tell you when we will do section 11, this will cover. Principal supply means supply. This we will see when in the section 8. Supply of goods or services. Keep this definition in mind. These are very important definitions. It will come when we will discuss the composite supply, mixed supply, then principal supply will be very integral part. Supply of goods or services which constituted the predominant element of composite supply. And to which other supply forming part, that composite supply or is ancillary. We'll be doing this types of supply. Section 8 we will be learning. Reverse charge, very important. There only I will teach you. Okay. When the supplier is not registered, okay, then there is a reverse charges. The recipient, if they are registered, they will be liable to pay the GST. Very important definition. Liability to pay the tax by the recipient of supply. Who is going to receive, they will be liable to pay. Not the person or not the taxable person who is supplying the goods. Okay, why? Because they are not registered. They don't have ESPN number. They can't pay. Okay. Then we have services, which is defined under section 2, subsection 102. Anything other than goods, money, security, include activity relating to use of money, conversion by cash or any other mode from one currency or denomination or other currency or denomination which is separate consideration is charged. Suppose the very important example of service. You went to your friend and you are asking some kind of exchange, lower denomination of money. Non-taxable supply. Very simple. Then Ashish, so suppose if you have given any services to your friend, taking their 100 rupees and giving 10 ka notes and not charging anything, will not be considered a service as per definition of CGST Act. But if you are taking a dollar, going to bank, getting the exchange in terms of Indian currency, and bank is charging, or suppose you are negating with 2000 rupees, bank is charging, or someone is charging consideration, then it will be a service. Till then, it will not be a service. Okay. Supplier in relation of any goods or services or both very important, shall mean a person of supplying said goods or services. So whosoever is supplied or supplying will be considered as definition of supplier under Section 2, Subsection 105. Taxable person. They have here. There is no definition of SSC or something contractor. Aisa kuch nahi hai. Only very simple definition. Taxable person. So under Section 2, Subsection 107. Person who is registered and liable to pay tax. I will teach you what is Section 22 and Section 24. 22 define the registration, which is compulsory. Registration, how you are making the registration of a person, which is mandatory as per the Act. And 24 talking about compulsory registration of an individual or any SSC or any taxable person. So this is all we are going to learn in subsequent section, which is there in our syllabus. Then taxable supply, which is there under Section 2, Subsection 108. Supply of goods or services or both, which is levable under tax, on which the tax is applicable. These are very small definition. Agent, which is defined under Section 2, Subsection 5. Anything, Dell Crader agent, okay, commission agent, auctioneer, everything is definition. Business, I think already we had a discussion of this. Business we have already taken care. Manufacturer. Taxable supply is also done. Supplier is also done. Manufacturer, manufacture under Section 2, Subsection 72, right from raw material, which has a different feature. We are transforming, like from batata to batata wala, is manufacture activity as per the definition of manufacture. So by this we have completed all the definitions which are important. Next time we are going to taxable territory. Next time we are going to discuss supply, types of supply, etc. If you have any doubt, feel free to contact, feel free to ask now, or whenever we will be having subsequent lecture, you can ask. But these definitions are very important. Okay, taxable territory means territory to which provisions of this Act is applicable. Things are clear, all definitions. Under CGST Act. next time when we will come, remaining sections are talking about GSTN, how GSTN to be formed. I have already discussed in earlier slide. So now directly we will be going for section 7, which is very important and integral for learning GST, that is supply.